Now that we've addressed our analog tags, we still have to apply an address to our digital input status. There are a few steps to this that can be different depending upon the format of the Modbus register, so let's get to it. As before, I'll click Edit to start building my address. Most of this dialog works the same, but our first difference is in the logic code. The available logic codes have changed, and the only one we're really concerned with now is the status SS true false, which reads a register, applies our configuration, and outputs a 1 or 0. To the right, we have two new register types, an output coil, a 0x register, and an input status, 1x register. From my register list, I can see that this register has a bitmap status, bitmap data type. On the next tab, this is explained further. I can read this register from either 4x register 2401 or 1x register 38416. Let's go with the former because its configuration is more interesting. I'll leave the number of registers at 1 and enter the address. If I used more registers, all the bits in all registers would have to match. Also, there is an advanced logic code for a status OR, which will match up to 4 registers and OR their statuses together. The last step is to set my bit mask. By default, all of the bits are ignored. I'm trying to match bit 0, so I'll click on it and change it to 1, meaning my digital tag will read 1 whenever bit 0 of register 2401 is high. If I have a simple single bit status, I can also invert the output, which can be useful for devices like negative logic breakers. In addition to a 1's mask, I can also apply a 0's mask. This is useful for enumerated statuses. A common example I've seen is a generator status. If I want a separate tag for generator run status, but the Modbus register is an enumerated value that returns, say, 2 when the generator is running, I can apply a more complex bit mask to address this. This is part of the flexibility of our Power Modbus driver. Now that I'm done here, I can click OK and view my tag's address again. Looking closely, my register address and its bit mask are both encoded into this address. At this point, all of my tags and categories on the left are black instead of red, indicating I've applied addresses to every tag. The last step here is to save my device type, but we may not be done yet. In the next video, I'll take an aside and discuss how we can create our own custom tags. If you don't need that, continue on to create a profile based on your device type. Either way, thank you.